Yeah, welcome to the largest commerce developer conference. Some of you have been here last year and the year before, I think, so you know the practice. We are always invited within the first speech to give some welcome warming words and an overview about what's going to happen here during the day. Some people are just coming in, so it's not yet outblown full here, but either way, we need to stick with the timetable and want to start punctually, and I give you some background why we actually do the developer conference and about some rules here for today. And later in this talk, Martin here will give you an overview about some important tracks and some of the most inspiring speeches and tracks here at the conference. So actually most asked question is, why do we do the developer conference? It's actually because you deserve it. When About You started in Hamburg, the Core Talks conference, like the big mothership of the commerce Core Talks, there was like in 2015 just a packed track of e-commerce topics in Hamburg, and some of you have been probably around in the big Core Talks event in Hamburg. So can you please raise your hands who have been at the big Core Talks event in Hamburg? Some of you. So you know the drill also from this conference. There had been like an e-commerce track in the at the conference in 2016. We decided together, okay, let's do like a joint event because there's so many diverse e-commerce topics that just deserve its own conference, and the industry is already grown so big, and it makes just sense to invite all people together to Berlin, which is also the headquarters of Spryker Systems, to discuss the recent e-commerce stuff from a developer perspective. It's a conference with like 300 to 500 attendees each year. That this helps a little bit over the, like 2 days to get in touch with everybody around you, and it's not like a super overwhelming conference, but it's like more networking type of conference. And some of the biggest brands in Germany, some of the biggest e-commerce brands in Germany have already been on stage, including such companies like Zalando, Otto, Amazon, Idealo, Flaconi. All those companies helped us to discuss what's going to happen in e-commerce right now, what's going to happen in commerce technology, and I hope those companies gave you some inspiring insights in their learnings. So what do you expect, or what can you expect for this year? We have a 2 days conference format, a format here in the Fourth Core Talks conference, and we are trying to cover all the recent topics from shop systems, scalings, IT management, and many, many more. Some of the curators here, Eileen is sitting in front of me, just in case you want to give her some big applause for getting together some of the coolest developers. And Martin, that's a moment for her. We always do an open paper call, an open call for papers each year. This year was not so good in terms of feedback we got compared to the years before. So I'd like to encourage you for the next Core Talks conferences upcoming next year and the year after. If there are some interesting topics you'd like to share, use this kind of opportunity to send him some papers so we can help you to get a slot on the track here. Now it's like 70 sessions, 8 theme tracks, 5 stages, and of course you've seen your personalized timetable already. And there's some rules behind our conference format, of course. So one of the most important stuff is, and that's probably the thing why it's remembered so good in the industry, popcorn and nachos isn't an all-you-can-eat buffet. Club Mate, all-you-can-drink. So some of you are working now in companies that are offering Club Mate and nachos probably during the office times. 5 years ago, when we started the conference, this wasn't the standard use case. So only like 2 or 3% of all the developers had unlimited access to Club Mate and nachos in the office. Today, it's probably 80% of you. But still, it kind of was started during the Core Talks format. What is very important for me is it's all about fun and respect here. It's not about like bashing other companies, not like bashing other technologies. It's really about sharing knowledge, and it's really about to get to know other people. Though, don't stick around in your already known network. Try to deep dive into other technologies. Try to exchange with other developers, because this is a chance right now to get to know other people. And I know some of you, or most developers, they are not so used to going to too many conferences, maybe like once or twice a year. Just use it. So networking is a much more important stuff than the stuff that's happening here in front of you, because that really sticks, the network and the connections you're making here. And just again, eat as much nachos as you can. It was always a dream for me as a kid when I was buying nachos at the cinema, and I'm from Eastern Germany, so I had the opportunity only when I was 15, before there was no nachos, only Salzstangen at the cinema. So eat as many nachos, and I use it, I promise you, I'm gonna eat as many nachos as I can at the conference, with all possible salsas on talk. Some org stuff. So we have a talk every hour. You can visit the booth stands of our sponsors in the foyer, and please use it. So such a conference would not been possible without all the sponsors also listed here: Commerce Tools, Verivox, Shopify, Idealo, Otto, Shopsys, and of course Spryker and About You. So please be fair and open, and pay some respect. There's lunch in the Kessel House, as like 50% of you have been here around like last year also. It's just the building at the other side of the Kulturbrauerei. I'm pretty sure you're gonna find it because everybody is following the food. It's a pretty common rule worldwide. We even offer some Pilates session, and there's a very cool conference party starting 6 p.m. at the same location where food is served later on. So then some days ago we had like 1st of April, and I'm following a couple of Twitter accounts doing some tech stuff, like Martin Fowler's and the likes. And when I was following those accounts, I found a lot of. Oh no! Before that, please do our conf game. So everybody has like a chip on its badge. You can win very, very cool prizes: drones, mobile phones, bags. Eileen, is this really the prizes you can get here, or is it just a stock photo? It's really the prizes you can get here. She's nodding. So it's really easy. You only need to answer some questions at the stand, and then there's like a very interesting way to find the winners. And it was always an overwhelming moment when people get their Nintendo NES first. I never got one because I'm from Eastern Germany. I already said so. I started with the Commodore Plus 4. I know. It's did not have the money for this C64. One very thing I've discovered at the Twitter accounts in the last days was, of course, we found a lot of those jokes. Yeah, here we see a JavaScript programmer deploying his Apple Foods joke. Yeah, it's very funny. Blah 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 blah. Very complex JavaScript. What a mess. So, but this conference is very different here. This is not about like doing too many nasty stuff about other programming languages and principles. So there's like a reason why people started those programming languages. There's a reason why big companies are using sometimes very old systems. And it's very important to understand why they did it, and what kind of obstacles they had to transform into other programming language or infrastructure setups. Please ask the people that are telling you the stories that are here. So again, networking is very, very important. The people that are sitting here in the crowd are at least as important as the people giving you some speeches. So give them also some respect and do the network. And I'd like to share why this is so important. We at Spryker, we are using personas in our sales approach. Personas is something you need in business development to understand what is like the desire and the problems of your target groups. And the one persona we are having in our business is called Wolfgang. Wolfgang is a 30 years IT manager. Yeah, he knows everything about IBM AS/400. Yeah, he was the best EDV Leiter in town. Actually, he was like promoted to head of IT, sometimes CTO. And he is usually reporting to the director or the Vorstand of finance and HR. And his job for the last 30 years was to spend the minimum amount of money possible for IT infrastructure. So he got rewards and he got his bonus when he was able to only spend 1 or 2% of the overall revenue of the company to handle SAP, to handle all the ERP systems. And this is persona is called Wolfgang, and we are meeting a lot of Wolfgangs in the industry. And now his IT leiter is saying, or his director is saying, Wolfgang, it's not good enough anymore. Wolfgang, we need to change. We are not agile enough. You need to be like all the cool guys sitting here. You need to evolve. Yeah, you need to become like this guy here because he releases much more. There's much more speed in IT organization. There's much more agility in the organization, and there's like popping out new stuff every day, new interfaces, new functionality. And that's actually Wolfgang's challenge, and it's very, very hard for Wolfgang to digest this approach because now he's not rewarded by saving money, but by using the same amount of money, but doing all the fancy stuff Amazon is doing and Zalando is doing. And that is very important to understand. And there we are finding a hurdle in the market when it comes to transformation. And I use the following charts usually when I do board presentations because it's the same in IT. So when you're looking at when we are looking at like old organization, or even like old IT infrastructure, you can perceive this like a goat. And we are using it also to describe old companies, so you can also use it for describe old IT infrastructure. And what is like the advantages of the goat? The goat is very easy to maintain. So a herd of goats, you only need some grass and a fence and some water, and it gives you a steady outcome in form of milk and meat. That is the job of the goat, and you only spend like 5 minutes a day to manage all the herd of goats. And now in IT and in digital transformation overall, there's the saying, there's no grass anymore in the future. Though the goat won't survive. You need to change. You need to become something like an antelope. And the antelope, in your case, it's the IT department of Zalando and Amazon. The antelope is very different compared to the goat. The antelope is able to start its day somewhere in the desert and then it's running and running and running and finding some water hole and finding some grass maybe and some different stuff to eat. And the antelope is even able to fight a lion. And then people are looking to the antelope and say, okay, our herd of goats, it's kind of boring. It's going to be dying either way. In the future, we need to become the antelope. Please, goats, please, dear Wolfgangs, look at the antelope, try to understand what the antelope is doing, and become like an antelope. So that is what we're seeing in IT transformation projects every day. So, and then Wolfgang is doing this, and all the likes of Wolfgang's, the Horsts and the Erhards is doing the same. So, and what is happening? Is there like, do we see companies that are transforming from goats to antelopes? No, they are transforming to smart goats. And the problem with the smart goat, with the smart Wolfgang is, so he has no time to handle all the old ERP AS/400 systems anymore. He knows everything about the release mechanisms of Amazon. He knows everything about the microservice architecture of Zalando. He even understands it, but there's no way he is able to transform his company or his IT structure into that way. And then he's starting to try to hire developers that are understanding the stuff, and then he's seeing developers are getting more and more expensive. So I just made up some salary form here. But what we're seeing, and it could be like the real salary development for PHP, senior PHP developers in Berlin. So it started like at 25K more or less 20 years ago, and now we are going right directly in the direction of 100K. That's getting more and more expensive, and this leads to a situation where Wolfgang is not feeling happy anymore. And you should use this kind of conference to understand this kind of quest and find solutions, because maybe 99% of the companies are in Wolfgang situations, or even like the younger Wolfgangs need to develop and become the new Antilope. And to understand how other companies are doing this and what their learnings were and how they managed like the education of existing developers' IT infrastructure into like new IT infrastructure to connect like, I don't know, voice interfaces or IoT interfaces. That's actually what this conference is about. So, and now I'd like to hand over to Martin. Please, if you want to understand how Spryker and About You is working, please visit some of the tracks my colleagues are giving are able to give you today here. So I would be very happy if we get some feedback on our approach to solve the Wolfgang challenge. But Martin is probably much more equipped to explain you what you can expect in the tracks. So please, Martin.
Thanks. Hi, everyone. It's nice to see as many people here. And I just want to get a short feedback. Alex already asked who was at the co-talks. Who was at the co-talks in Hamburg this year? Nobody. There was one. There's like two. OK, maybe three. OK, so not a lot. OK. Just wanted to know because before I start, I wanted to get a short review on that. Okay, so I'm going to start with the people from Spryker and About You. Then I'm going to talk about our general themes and the program. And I'm going to give you a completely unopinionated impression of which talks I think you should go to and have a look. Okay, so we're going to start with the two Spryker talks. There is Marco and Dennis, which are doing some talks on taming complexity through automation. And then Dennis is going to talk on the second day about sticky APIs and connecting bricks and enter the global IT system. Then from About You, we have me and Jana. And I'm going to talk to you about how to settle a unicorn. And if you want to know what that actually means, you're going to have to listen to my talk and come to my talk. And then Jana is going to talk to you about how we grew, failed, and learned, and then scaled in our IT infrastructure and just as a company in general. OK, so before I start with the tracks, I want to point out two things. So one is I love being at IT and general developer conferences because it's basically the only place where I can say, hey, I'm a developer and not get asked to fix someone's computer. So, and the other thing I want to point out is how important the speakers are. Of course, obviously, there would be no conference without the speakers, but I think a good metaphor for how public speaking is like public speaking is a bit like skiing. So when you're down at the bottom of the slope, you look up and you're like, oh, that looks easy, I could do that. And then when you're actually standing on top of the slope or on the stage, you're going to look down or up in this case, and you're going to say, oh, fuck, this is way harder than it looked from the bottom. So I want to just give a big applause and big thank you to all the speakers that are here, and they are sharing their knowledge with us. And yeah, they are the people that make this possible. So thank you. Yeah, we have 8 theme tracks this year. And me and Eileen, we met like in August or something like last year. And we sit down together for quite some time and discussed what we should talk about, how we should put together the themes and what we should put together as a topics. And we decided on these 8, and I'm going to talk a bit about each of those in a second. And IT organization, for me as a developer, IT organization is always a bit like, oh yeah, there's a lot of buzzwords like agile, we're using Scrum, we are using Kanban. But to be honest, IT organization is really important for our work. And even though some developers might not like to admit it, but IT organization and doing IT organization right is really important. And I think what I would like to look at is the talk from Nuno. It's today at 16 o'clock in the cinema. And he's going to talk about how HelloFresh became from a startup to a global leader and what they learned for the tech teams from that. So I think that's going to be really interesting. Then IoT. IoT is, I think, an amazing topic, and the amount of devices we have every year getting more and more being connected via the internet is just crazy. Everything has a device. Like, you're not just having smartphones, but also smart toothbrushes, smart microwaves, smart the air conditioning is talking to the freezer, and yeah, everything is interconnected, and that's gonna be even gonna get even more with 5G. And I think the talk from Kelly today at 11 is gonna be really interesting, because he's going to talk about how 5G is gonna impact. And then maybe at 2030 or sometime, when 5G is coming to Germany, we can actually use that talk. Next up is a talk from Roland. Roland has been at the Co-Talks a few times before, and I loved his talk on the Co-Talks this year, last year, and I think this talk is going to be amazing too. It's software quality equals health. Sadly, not in English, but I think we are enough German, we have a big enough German audience to fill that cinema as well. So that's going to be today at 17 o'clock. And yeah, as I said, I listened to the talk at the Co-Talks in October, and it was really good. Then we have Ulrike. Ulrike is talking about on-premise cloud, headless, and all these things that seem to be a really big topic in e-commerce in general and IT. And she's going to share our her opinion, experience in that on those topics, and that's today at 16 o'clock, and I think that's going to be really cool in the cinema. Infrastructure and ops, there is going to be a talk from Philipp Krenn. He's working for Elasticsearch, and he's going to talk about how to handle mod security and logging. And infrastructure and DevOps, one of a good friend of mine is working in that sector, and it's always amazing to me how few people there are doing actually operations, and it seems like the operations teams is the bottleneck for every company that I know of, at least. And yeah, I think even if you're not an ops or infrastructure guy or person in general, just I think you should go there and just listen to what he has to say. We need more operations people. That's my personal favorite, data and AI craftsmanship. I'm really into AI or machine learning, to be more specific. I think AI is mostly what it says on PowerPoint, and machine learning is really what the people that know a bit more would be writing. Like, if you write Python, that's machine learning, and AI is mostly used on PowerPoint. So, Christian is going to talk about debugging AI, how to debug AI. And I think that's really important, because for those people who know a bit more about machine learning and AI in general, that's not an easy task. And I'm really, really looking forward to hearing what he has to say and how you can do that. And that's also happening in this cinema today at 3 o'clock. Customer interaction and activation is, especially for e-commerce and commerce in general, I think really important. And there is a lot of topics. And at About You, one of my best friends is working in the customer activation marketing. And I had a really opinionated opinion on how useful that is. And since I do, I spend a lot of time with her, I actually get how important that is even for us as a developer, because they are basically enabling us to, or they make the people come to our product and make them actually use our product and show them how great our product is. And Raphael is going to talk about how to build a voice commerce experience with Alexa, I guess, because he's from Amazon. And that's going to be tomorrow at 14 o'clock in this cinema as well. And also, next to AI, my favorite track, application development, because I'm usually I used to be a software developer and I still love coding. Coding is the best. And I think if I could choose any job, I would always be a software developer. Crafting something with my brain and then actually having a product that I can show is amazing. And Thomas is going to talk about a really, really cool topic, I think, and how to get started with PHP on AWS Lambda, AWS Lambda, sorry. And I think that's going to be really cool. Microservices is really cool. It doesn't matter if you're using Cloud Functions or Azure Functions, I think it's called, or AWS Lambda. It's really cool, and I think that's going to be a real good insight into that topic. So if you want to get started with that, that's today, like right after this talk in Cinema 4. Then I want to say thanks. So besides the speakers, of course, there's always the sponsors that make an event like this possible as well. And yeah, just I want to give a big thanks to all the sponsors that enabled us to do this conference again year and year over. And yeah, big thanks to them. And I hope we will be able to do many more conferences and have many more people here to share the knowledge. Short pitch for the co-talks. So there were not a lot of people, and I know, who's from Berlin here? Okay. What's the excuse of the other ones that haven't been at the co-talks in Hamburg? Okay, none. So the co-talks is like this conference, just even more technical. We don't have a focus on e-commerce. We have a more broader spectrum on technical topics. We have I introduced a VR AR track last year, and yeah, if you're into coding at all, just take a look. The call for papers is open. If you've ever considered sharing your knowledge, go ahead and get involved and yeah, apply for a talk at the Co-Talks 2019. And I would really like to see you there and then meet you at the speaker dinner or just at the conference. We have like 1,500 people there. And it's always an amazing event, especially the party on Thursday. And yeah, also I want to thank the event and Auger team. The girls have done an amazing job over the last few months. We had a switch in the Auger team, but they still handled it really well. And I want to give a big shout out to them for organizing this, making all this possible. None of what me and Eileen, all the speakers, all the sponsors would have not mattered if it weren't for them. So big thank you and a big applause to them. Yes, and then also I want to thank me and Eileen, of course. no, that's just what we do. You don't have to thank us. And then I want to thank our design team who made these amazing sheets and just in general all the graphics for our conference all over here. So every graphic you see is from them. And yes, that's it. And I hope every one of you enjoys the Co-Talks Commerce 2019. Thank you.